Hello guys, today I'm gonna show you my first 3D printing project, Sparky. Here is the printer I used. It's called Tevo Michelangelo, which is very compact for beginners. It's very considerable that we don't have to think a lot for settings because there's already a preset from the SD card. But be noticed to save and rename each preset in the software otherwise. Once we finish the bed leveling and software setting, it's good to start our project. All the parts took me around 4 hours. The speed is very fast. As you can see, the detail is very nice. Now I'm using a plier to clean it out. It's up to you to choose the tools like scalpel, knife, file, and so on. Before painting, do not forget to wear a gas mask. I put a filter primer on its surface. Then I sand it by using the sandpaper and water. It will be a little bit smoother but not much better than before. So I think I'm supposed to spend more time on this step. To paint different color to each body, I'm gonna use the tape. Regarding the colors, we have two options. One is the spray paint and the other is acrylic color. It actually depends on your project and what you need because the spray paint is more efficient. It took me a few minutes to finish almost all. However, the result looks very matte. After that, I realized that I don't have the brown spade for the button and wheels. Then I turned to use the acrylic color. I put the medium liquid, dark yellow, black color, and some water, then mix. I'm not sure if I should use the high flow acrylic color instead because sometimes the airbrush nozzle clog up with the liquid. That took me a while because I have to clean it out by using the alcohol liquid. Nonetheless, I would highly recommend you to use the airbrush because each layer is very thin and uniform. Finally, I got all the parts finished. Now I'm gonna use the hot glue gun to put them together. For the nose, it's up to you to add the lighting effects. I use the hot glue, the tape, and spray color. But a lot of my friends said it looks like it's not. Okay. To avoid the hot glue being annoyed, I would suggest you to put a heat-resistant mat on the table. Well, here is the final result. In conclusion, I love this printer very much because it's easy enough for beginners like me. All are already set up, so I save that time to figure out problems such as the infill or maybe the flow. I will also leave the guideline to you. One problem may happen is that the fixed stuff may not glue very well on the non-heated bed. That's it for today's video. Many thanks to Hansi from NerdForge sharing his skill with me. Also, many thanks to you guys for watching this video till the end. Any ideas? You're welcome to leave some comments on our channel. Thanks for watching. and see you next time.